video because I would like to share a personal experience, and I didn't feel like this is something that I would like to write about. I think this is something that I would like that people listened, and yeah, that came from my own words. And this is a thing that happened when I was a child. During 8 years, I have been sexually abused by my neighbor and by a friend of the family. And maybe you think, oh, well, in countries like Peru, this is maybe common. But I have been living in a good family. We are not rich, but we were living in a good neighborhood, we can say. And my parents, they have good jobs, we can say. But this was not the impediment for this kind of things happens to a child. No? It's never a place or a country or whatever for stop this kind of things to happen. Well, the thing is that my earliest memories about my life, like, started when I was 4 years old, and during all these years, from 4 years old and until my 12 years, I had been passing through this situation, and I never told anybody about this. My mother knows about this. And the reason it was because this, what was happening to me, it was never a reason to stop me living. It was never a reason to become sad, or was never a reason to find the society or the reality as a bad place to be. I never feel as a victim. I, of course, as a child, I didn't understood why it was happening this to me, why these people is doing this to me. After some years, I start to realize. But when this was happening, I didn't knew what was going on. I didn't have any kind of knowledge of this. My parents never told me. And of course, it's not their fault. They were working, and they trust these people. And this is also a message for everybody, that what we are doing now in our society, we don't have time to take care of our own children. Like a woman, for example, like, we need to go and work, we need to leave our children with nannies or with other persons. And I'm not saying that we need to become, to don't trust people. We need just to be aware that what we are doing with our lives. And this, as a child, was really difficult. The way that I deal with this is when I started to have conflicts when I was becoming a teenager, because then this my neighbor, he was interfering then in my relationships. Because one day I remember I was playing, and then he came to bring me to his house, and then is when I started to say, no, this is wrong what you're doing, and I'm not going there. And then I was thinking, like, how I need to deal with this, and what these people say to me, that was that they will kill my parents if I say something. So then I was just wondering what I will do. With the little knowledge and the little information that I have in that time. And once, when I took the decision, okay, I will say now to my father what is happening, that he can stop this. What happened was that day I went to, it was a new bakery, and my father sent me to buy bread. And I was going there to buy the bread, but then at some point I didn't want to go anymore to buy bread, because what was going on in this bakery, in this new bakery, was the guy that was working, that I think it was like 18 years old and I was 10, he was also bothering me. And I don't know why, but he was just bothering me and saying, oh, you so nice little girl. And the way that he was looking at me, it was not the way that normally people look at children. And I knew this because I was passing through this sexual abuse with the family, of the friend of the family, and my neighbor. And I just say, okay, now this also can happen, so I need to do something And my father actually, he asked me like, why you don't want to go and buy bread? And then I need to say to him like, because of the guy on the store is bothering me. And then my father, he gets so crazy. He took the motorbike and he ride the motorbike with me, and he punched the guy in the face, and I was there. And then the day I say like, oh my God, what will happen if I say to my parent what my neighbor and the friend is doing to me? He will kill them, and then he will go to jail, and this will be just a big drama with where anybody ends happy. So what I did was to talk with the parents of my neighbor, because when all this started, I just remembered that I was 4 years old, and maybe he was 12, but he was teenager. And the other guy, yeah, he was older, but the other guy, he moved from the city, so I didn't have to deal with that, and I don't remember his name. But with my neighbor, I went to the parents, and I explained to them what was happening, and after this, everything, what he was doing to me, stopped, and I didn't saw my neighbor for a while. I think they punched him, I don't know. Now this neighbor, I forgive him. I never told my father about this. My mother, she knows, because when I was 18, I decided to share with her this, what was going on, because she couldn't understand some of my reactions when the neighbors and the friend of the family was in the house, because it was so difficult as a child to know how to deal with this situation. And that these people was in the house, they were for Christmas, and they were going there, they left me with these people, and that they never notice these things going on. And the point with this is that as a child I have the capacity to forgive and to understand that if I don't stop myself with the thing that is happening, if I cannot see that how many people can be damaged because of the actions of one person. And this was happening to me, so it was my decision to know what to do. And I decided to forgive. I decide to forgive. And if you're passing now through a situation that is very different, but it's about forgiveness, if a small child can forgive these kind of things, then why we other people, we cannot do it? Why we want to take our problems and our pain so much, we want to hold as a small baby, that is our reason to be unhappy, and that is our reason that we cannot go forward in life. And this is what I wanted to share with all of you, and that you can find a little bit of happiness in your life, and motivation, that is nothing that can stop you to be happy, nothing. It's just up to you, it's how you deal, how you face with the things in your life. And all these things in my childhood just push me to understand more and more, or to try to understand what is the point to be human, what is the point to be here, why children need to experience these things, and why other persons need to do this to children. And that's was one reason that also I become a lawyer, because I thought that becoming a lawyer, I will do good things, that I will be the good person, that I will protect people with the laws. But when I was working there in the government, I met criminals, I met victims, I met everything. And just my conclusion at the end was that if all these people, like the criminals, if all of them will have the opportunity to find love, if the parents of these criminals will have the opportunity to teach them how to love themselves, then we will have a completely, completely different society. And that's why I left all this law profession in aside for a while, and I start to go deep in the understanding with the shamanism and the work with the plants. And ayahuasca always was giving me confirmations about how important it is to transform the individual from the inside, how important it is to bring love to the humans, that they know that they are not alone, that there is light, that it's a reason here for me. And when we can feel this love, then the change will start to happen, and then we will stop all these sad situations that are going on in our planet. So I hope that that you don't judge this video, that you don't think too much in about, okay, she's telling me like I need to forgive, even when the thing is unforgivable, but just to let go whatever you are carrying on you, let go, forgive yourself. It was not your fault, and it's not fault of anybody. It's just life, and we are experiencing it, and we need to take the lections and move on. So thank you, and a lot of love and gratitude for all of you. See you.